Hello everyone, myself Mr. Sunil sir and I welcome you all at Nagesh Kazgi Orchid School TV channel. And today we are going to learn about the first topic of science, that is food and health. Students, as we all know that food and health are very important thing in our life. Why? Because if we want to live a healthy life, then we must have to take a healthy food. So, in this topic, food and health, we are going to learn about food and health in detail. But before starting the lesson, I want to ask you one question, that is, why do we eat food? As we all know that food is very important thing. So, let's tell me, why do we eat food? Or what are the importance of food? Okay, food is energy, food gives energy. Okay, food helps to work. Again, what are the other importance of food? Food make our body strong and healthy. Okay, that means food is very important thing for all of us, and we eat food to get energy to work and to play, to grow and to make our body strong and healthy. So, in this topic, we have to learn about nutrients in food, different groups of food, balanced diet, food preservation and different methods of food preservations. Also, we have to learn about different types of diseases and prevention of diseases, etc. Now, we will see the first point of the lesson, that is nutrients in food. If anybody know the meaning about the nutrients, then you can tell what is mean by nutrient or what substances we called as nutrients. Nutrients are substances that are present in food and which help our body to live, to grow and to be healthy. So, what is mean by nutrients? See, nutrients are substances which are present in food. Nutrients are substances which are present in food and help our body to live, to grow and to be healthy. So, nutrients are very important in our food. The food we eat provide us with a range of nutrients. That means, every food contains different types of nutrients, and there are five main kinds of nutrients, that are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. These are five main kinds of nutrients, like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. These are five main kinds of nutrients. And to getting these all nutrients, we must have to eat different kinds of food. That means, we have to eat variety of food. Why? Because different nutrients are found in different foods. If we eat only one type of food, then our body did not get all the nutrients for our body. And to avoid that, we have to include variety of nutrients in our daily diet. And as well as working of all the nutrients is also different. That means, some nutrients provide our body with energy, some help it to grow and some help it to fight against diseases. For example, nutrients like carbohydrates and fats provide our body with energy. Nutrients like proteins provide our body with or help our body to grow. And nutrients like vitamins and minerals help our body to fight against diseases. In this way, nutrients are helpful and work differently according to their quality. So, to get all the nutrients, we must have to eat a variety of foods every day. That means we have to include different types of vegetables, different types of fruits, milk, milk products, fish, vegetables, grains, pulses, etc. When we include this type of food in our daily diet, then we get proper nutrition to our body. And on the basis of different work of nutrients, on the different work of nutrients, food have been divided into three groups, that are energy giving foods, bodybuilding foods, and third one is a protective food. In this group, food have been divided on the basis of nutrients and their work. So, let's see in detail about the energy giving foods. Energy giving foods means the food which provide our body with energy or which help our body to give quick energy. Nutrients like carbohydrates and fats. Gives most of the energy to our body to work and to play. Therefore, they are called as energy giving food. Carbohydrates and fats gives most of the energy to our body for to work, to play. Therefore, they are called as energy giving food. So, which food item contains carbohydrates and fats? Food items which contains sugar and starch are kinds of carbohydrates. That means, the food in which sugar and starch are containing, that food items gives us carbohydrates. So, sugar and starch are kinds of carbohydrates that give you quick energy, When we eat sugar and starch, then our body gets quick energy to work. So, some food items like rice, wheat and other grains like jowar, bajra, etc., as well as chapati, bread, noodles, potato, sugar are also some examples of carbohydrate giving food. That means, when we include all that food in our diet, then our body gets different, our body gets the nutrient like carbohydrate. Along with carbohydrate, fat is also known as energy giving food. But fats did not get digested directly. Why? Because they are getting stored in our body and our body can use them later to get energy. Fats do not get digested directly, they are getting stored in our body and our body can use them later to get energy. So, fats helps our body to stay warm. This is the very important function of fat, that to keeping our body warm. So, our body needs a very less amount of fats. Why? Because if we include excess amount of fat in our diet, then our body becomes overweight or we and also causes some diseases like obesity. For that, we have to include very less amount of fat in our daily diet. Why we have to include fats in less amount? Because if we include fats in more amount, then our body become overweight and also causes some diseases like obesity. Food product or food items like oil, butter, ghee, nuts, cheese and so on are the rich sources of fat. That means, when we include oil, butter, ghee, nuts, cheese, etc. in our daily diet, then our body gets nutrients like fats. So, this is about energy giving food. Carbohydrates and fats are known as energy giving food. Let's see about the next group of food, that is body building foods. As we know that some food help our body to grow, some help us to make muscles, make skin and also making blood also. So, that is why they are called as body building food. Proteins help our body to grow. They help in making muscles, blood and skin. That is why they are called as a body building food. They also help in repairing our body when it is damaged. Therefore, proteins are called as body building food. Protein help our body in the growth of muscles, blood and skin. That is why they are called as body building food. When we include food items like fish, meat, cheese, chicken, milk, eggs, pulses, nuts, then our body gets nutrient like proteins, which help our body to build muscles, blood and skin. So, proteins are called as body building food. Which nutrient are called as body building food? Protein. Proteins are called as body building food. Let us see next group of food, that is protective foods. Protective foods. Protective foods means the food which protect our body from diseases as well as keep our body healthy. So, which are that nutrients? That are vitamins and minerals. As we all know that some nutrients help our body to fight against diseases and keep our body healthy. Vitamins and minerals protect our body from diseases. Vitamins and minerals protect our body from diseases. Therefore, they are called as protective food. Protective food are known as vitamins and minerals are known as protective food. Vitamins and minerals are needed by our body in small amount to stay fit and healthy. Vitamins and minerals are needed by our body in small amounts to stay fit and healthy. Why? Because they protect our body from diseases. So, we have to include that in our daily diet. There are many kinds of vitamins and minerals. For example, vitamin A, B, C, D, E and vitamin K are some of the examples of vitamins. What are the names of vitamins? Vitamins A, B, C, D, E and vitamin K are examples of vitamins. When we include variety of fruits, different types of vegetables, eggs, meat, then our body gets that type of nutrients. That means fruits, vegetables, eggs, meat are some of the resources of vitamins. Like vitamins, our body also needs different types of minerals like calcium, phosphorus and iron. These are some minerals which are needed by our body or which needs to our body to become healthy. So, milk products, beans, dry fruits, meat and fish are some of the good sources of different minerals. What are the names of minerals? Minerals like calcium, phosphorus and iron. And which food product provide our body with minerals? Food products like beans, dry fruits, meat and fish are some of the good sources of different minerals. Okay. Apart from different types of food or different nutrients, our body also need water and refuge. Why? Because without of water and refuge, our body is unable to digest the food. So, we have to include water and refuge into our diet to digest the food. This is very important for our body. So, let's see about water and refuge. Water and refuge. In addition to nutrients, our body also needs water and refuge. Almost 2/3 of our body part is made up of water. Near about 2/3 of our body part is made up of water. It is the main part of our blood and we cannot live without of water. Water also helps in digestion of food. Our body uses water in all its cells, organs and tissues to help regulate its temperature and maintain other body functions. Water helps our body to absorb nutrients from food. In this way, water is very useful for our body. Now, see about roughage. What is mean by roughage? Roughage is also called as fiber. Another name of roughage is fiber. So, roughage means the part of our food that cannot be digested by the body. What is mean by roughage? Roughage or fiber is that part of our food that cannot be digested by the body. Then what is the use of roughage, or in what way roughage is useful for our body? See, roughage adds only bulk to food and helps our muscle to push the food through intestines. It also helps our body get rid of undigested food. Roughage does not provide any nutrients to our body, but is an essential component of our food. That means roughage did not contain any of the nutrients like carbohydrates, minerals, fats, vitamins, any of that, but also it is very essential. Why? Because it helps our body to digest the food that we have eaten. When we get the roughage? When we eat whole grains and pulses, potatoes, fresh fruits and vegetables in our diet, then our body get roughage. That means whole grains and pulses, potatoes, fresh fruits and vegetables are some of the rich sources of roughage. In this way, roughage is also very important component of our food. So, we have to include water and roughage in our body. This is about nutrients, groups of food, water and roughage. So, next part of our lesson is of a balanced diet. When we include all the nutrients like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals along with water and roughage in our diet, then our diet becomes balanced diet. It gives our body or it helps our body in the growth of muscles, blood and in every way it helps our body. So, what is mean by balanced diet? To build a strong and healthy body, we need all the nutrients in right amount. We cannot get all the nutrients from only one type of food. To get all the nutrients, we have to eat different types of foods. So, what is mean by balanced diet? A diet that contains the right amount of all nutrients including water and roughage is called a balanced diet. What is the definition of balanced diet? A diet that contains the right amounts of all nutrients including water and roughage is called a balanced diet. So, it is very there is very confusion in selecting balanced diet. Why? Because there are different types of food, different types of vegetables, different types of grains, and we don't know about that which food or which fruit provide with protein, carbohydrate or minerals. To avoiding the confusion or to making easier for us to select a balanced diet, again food have been divided into four groups. It is only for our health to select a balanced diet. Food is again divided into four groups. Let's see what are they. They are cereal groups, fruits and vegetable groups, milk group and protein group. When we eat food from each group, our body get a balanced diet. So let's see about cereal group. What is mean by cereal group, or which food comes in that group? Let's see. Cereal means grains. When we include food products which are made from grains, like chapati, bread, noodles, then our body gets carbohydrates and minerals. That means when we select food from this group, cereal group, then our body gets carbohydrates and minerals. To getting carbohydrates and minerals, we have to eat different kinds of grains like wheat, jowar, rice, etc. And also we have to include food products which are made from grains. So next group is of fruits and vegetable groups. As we know that there are different types of fruits and vegetables, and when we include fruits and vegetable in our diet, then our body gets different types of vitamins, minerals and some amount of carbohydrates. That means fruits and vegetable group provide our body with vitamins, minerals and carbohydrates. So next group is of milk group. When we eat food from that group, our body gets proteins, fats and minerals. So which food items comes in this group? The food products which are made from milk, like ghee, butter, curd, cheese, etc. When we include that type of food into our diet, then our body gets proteins, fats and minerals. That means milk group provide our body with proteins, fats and minerals. Fourth group is of protein group. When we include food from that group, our body get proteins and fats. So which food items gives us proteins? Food items like pulses, beans, chicken, meat, eggs, fish, that are some of the examples of food which provide our body with protein. And when we eat food from that group, our body gets proteins and fats. In this way, we can select our balanced diet. And to get a balanced diet, we have to eat a food from each groups every day. That means we have to eat food from cereal group, fruits and vegetable group, milk group and protein group to get all the nutrients. As well as we have to eat some amount of fat. That means the food should also contain a small amount of fat. When we include all these food material in our daily diet, then our body gets a balanced diet. Okay. Now, see the next part of the lesson, that is preserving the nutrients in food. Preserving the nutrients in food. So tell me, what is mean by food preservation, or what is mean by food preservation, or meaning of preservation food, preserving food? See, food preservation is the process of creating food to stop the spoilage, loss of quality, edibility or nutritional value. What is mean by food preservation? Food preservation is the process of creating food to stop the spoilage, loss of quality, edibility or nutritional value. That means avoid food from spoiling and to consume or to prevent nutrients from losing. For that we have to use different methods of food preservation. What happens if we are not preserving the foods? See, if we do not preserve the food, nutrients from food or nutrients from it becomes lost. If we do not preserve the foods, nutrients from it becomes lost. Nutrients from it means nutrients from food become lost, and it starts smelling bad. For example, some food product or some food items like bread, if we are not using that on particular time, then it's smelling bad, as well as some fruits and vegetables also smelling bad, when if we are not using them on time or if we not preserve them properly, then they start smelling bad. Then germs are growing on it and it becomes spoiled. What happens? Germs are also starting to grow on it and it becomes spoiled. And when we eat such spoiled food, can causes food poisoning and some stomach diseases. For that, or to avoid that, we have to preserve the food. If we not preserve the food, what happens? If we do not preserve the foods, nutrients from it becomes lost and it starts smelling bad. Germs are growing on it and it becomes spoiled, or food becomes spoiled. And when we eat such spoiled food, can causes food poisoning and stomach diseases. See next question. Why nutrients from food get destroyed? Why nutrients from food get destroyed? There are many reasons due to that nutrients from food becomes lost, and that are using wrong methods of cooking and storing food. That means if we are not using right methods of cooking, that means if we are using extra water, less water, or not using proper method of cooking, then nutrients from food become lost, as well as wrong method of storing food. That means if we are not covering the food, or we not cover the food, what happens? Some insects are sitting on that and germs are started to grow on that. Some insects carry some germs also with them and causing food to spoil. This is the first reason, that's why food become lost, that is using wrong methods of cooking and storing food. Second way is washing fruits and vegetables after cutting. Generally what we do, we bring vegetables and fruits from the market and we cut them after washing. But what happens with that? When we do so, the nutrients from that vegetables and fruits becomes or getting washed along with the water. So don't wash fruits and vegetables after don't wash the fruits and vegetables before, so after cutting. That means washing fruits and vegetables after cuttings may lose some nutrients. Washing fruits and vegetables after cutting may lose the nutrients. Third point is that throwing water from cooked food. Throwing water from the cooked food. Generally what we do, we cook food in water and in excess water. Then what will we do? What we do after cooking the food, we throw that water, and along that water nutrients are also get washed. So to preserve nutrients from the food, avoid throwing water from cooked food. Next way by which nutrients are lost are keeping cooked food, fruits and vegetables for longer time. That means if we are not using cooked food, fruits and vegetables on time, it becomes lost. So students, with this point of the lesson, we will stop here today. But before concluding our session, it's very important to take a short review of the points that we had learned today. So tell me what we had learned today. First of all, we learn about the importance of food, uses of food. Afterwards, we learn about different nutrients from the foods, that are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. After that, we also learn about different groups of food, that are energy giving foods, bodybuilding foods and protective food. As well as we learn that groups of foods in detail along with water and roughage. Afterwards, we learn about a balanced diet and the groups of food that provide our body with a balanced diet. Then after that we just take some introduction about the preservation of nutrients in food. I hope you understood the lesson or you understood the things that I have explained you today. We will see the remaining points in our next session. Till that, you have to revise the things that we have learned today. Thank you.